Okay, so we are now going to start with an experiment which is crowded plate technique. So we had seen that we had mixed the soil and then let it settle. So after settling, this is how it looks. Now the next step is doing a spread plate using 1 ml of the sample. Okay. So now we will be doing the spread plate technique, where the first step is taking out the sterile pipette. So we will open this under in between the burners so as the sterility of the pipette to be maintained. Here I am going to use 5 ml pipette because it is easier for me to pick 1 ml from the 5 ml pipette. And the pipette tip has to be kept within the burners. Alright. Next step is to take 1 ml of the water and this is raw. So now we will be doing a spread plate technique for doing the crowded plate. Taking 1 ml of the clear supernated, supposed to add it on a nutrient agar plate so that all the microorganisms will get equal chance to grow. And since the sample is a soil sample, there will be lot and lot of microorganisms present. So the next step is spreading, to be done by a sterile spreader. So we dip the spreader in alcohol and flame sterilize it so that any organism present on the spreader will die and will not cause the contamination. The water gets absorbed onto the nutrient agar plate. Here we will be looking for overcrowding and any antibiotic producer that we are able to catch or find out. Again, we are supposed to flame sterilize the spreader so that any organisms present would die. I'm going to do 2 plates so that the chances of getting an antibiotic producer increase. Again, I have taken 1 ml of sample and I am going to add it onto a nutrient agar plate. So now I don't need this pipette, so I am just removing it from the sterile zone. I have dipped my spreader into alcohol and I will be flame sterilizing it like this so that any organism present on the spreader will now die off. And using this spreader, we will spread the water sample. Now the plate has become dry. The water has been absorbed. So now we can finally clean our spreader so that any organism present in that water sample will now die. And now we will keep these plates at 37 degrees Celsius for incubation for around 24 hours and then observe the growth. Looking at the results of the crowded plate technique, they had incubated the plate for around 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius and let the organisms grow. After the growth, what we are seeing here is that there is a distance between two colonies, as we can see. The central colony is pushing away these other organisms, which means that the central colony is producing some antibiotic substance which is not allowing rest of them to grow near it. Similarly, another colony that we can see, what we are seeing here are the results of the crowded plate technique. As we can see, this central colony is pushing away other organisms and therefore an halo has been created. This is because the central colony here is producing certain antibiotic substances which are killing the other organisms and not allowing them to come near this organism. If we look at the plate, at this area there is no antibiotic producer, so therefore there is no halo seen, but here we can see this tiny colony is pushing all other microorganisms away from it, and therefore we can see a smaller halo around it. A bigger halo can be seen here, and the biggest is seen here where the central colony is producing so much substance, antibiotic substance, that so many organisms are being pushed back because they are getting killed when they come into this zone of clearance. So now what we can do is we can pick up this colony, antibiotic producing colony, and check for its antimicrobial activity using other test organisms.